Hey, welcome to Be Remarkable once again this week. The word for this week is growth. What does growth mean? Is growing in the physical sense is what we did when we were children, growing from babies to adulthood. We grew while we were in school in our knowledge and in our relationships. But what do we do once we become adults and we're no longer challenged in that academic level? A number of us are fortunate enough to be in careers or occupations that challenges us to continue growing. We have employers or companies that seek out growth in us. But many of us, especially us women, don't always have that opportunity as much as maybe in other settings would. So how do we grow and why is that important? Let me tell you a story about me. About 5 years ago, my husband and I went through a very, very tough time, not in our marriage per se, but in our business. So what happened? I began telling myself things up here that were not positive whatsoever. They were actually very detrimental to myself and detrimental to my marriage. I used words, I used the blame game, things that I would have never said to my husband or said to myself. And they were horrible. So I decided I don't want to be like this anymore. I don't want to live in this context anymore. So what did I do? I began seeking out how to improve. I first started off with listening to podcasts about becoming a better person. And as I began to do that, I realized that this has to be something I have to commit to and do on a daily basis. And as I began to do that, I began to tell myself different things up here, and as a result, my heart became different. Of course, I had to ask for forgiveness from my husband, apologize. He graciously received it, and I now have a whole different outlook on life. So how do you grow? You can do things such as audible.com. You can download audiobooks. I challenge myself every month to listen to one audiobook while I'm driving, while I'm getting dressed in the morning, while I am washing dishes, I will turn it on. You can read a book every month. I put a book by my nightstand and every night I read at least one chapter of the book or 10 or 15 minutes worth. And then what else can you do? You can sit under the leadership and direction of other people. Listen to what they have to teach and train you. Of course, we've talked about the mentor relationship. That is a wonderful way to grow. And if you are a mentor, you have to grow in order to become the guide for your mentee. Hey guys, look and seek ways to grow this week. We will meet you again next week on Be Remarkable.